Dear students, now we are going to discuss condition for oscillation, that is also known as Berkashian criterion. There are two important conditions to be used in oscillator circuits. Whichever electronic circuits satisfy these two conditions, those can be used as oscillators. Okay, the first condition is modulus of A beta is equal to 1. That is, the magnitude of loop gain A beta is equal to unity. The second condition is total phase shift around the closed loop is either 0 degree or 360 degree. Do you all understand? So in this video, we are going to prove these two conditions for oscillator circuits. So for that, we can consider an inverting amplifier with open loop gain A. This is the basic inverting amplifier circuit, so in which we have to give the input signal Vi and we can get the output signal as A into Vi. Since the amplifier is inverting amplifier, it produces 180 degree phase shift. So you can see this 180 degree phase shift in this waveform. So here it starts from positive, here it starts from negative. So this is the basic inverting amplifier. So we are going to use this inverting amplifier in our oscillator circuit. This is the basic oscillator circuit. It consists of basic inverting amplifier with gain A and a positive feedback with gain beta. There is no input given to this circuit. Here we can get the output voltage from this amplifier due to the DC supply voltage, not from this input signal. Okay, this output signal is given as input to this feedback, then we can get the feedback signal as VF, that is given as an input to this basic inverting amplifier. Do you all understand this concept? So feedback signal drives the amplifier circuit. So here inverting amplifier produces 180 degree phase shift. So if we are going to give input signal, here we can assume there is a fictitious input signal. Fictitious means what? We can imagine there is an input signal which starts from positive. So obviously we can get the 180 degree phase shifted output as VO. So it starts from negative side. Then that can be taken as input to this feedback. So this positive feedback gives 180 degree phase shift to make the feedback signal in phase with the input signal. Do you all understand this concept? So totally there are 360 degree. So one is from inverting amplifier, another one is from positive feedback. So the first condition of Berkashian criterion is achieved. So next one. So if the feedback is adjusted so that the loop gain A beta is equal to 1. Do you all understand this diagram? So this is the simplified diagram here. Here we are not giving any input signal. This feedback signal drives the amplifier. Okay. So here we can consider a fictitious voltage Vi applied at the input of the amplifier. Actually it is an imaginary one. We can assume there is an input voltage. Okay. So here gain of the amplifier is A, that is equal to output voltage by input voltage. From this we can get VO is equal to A into VI. Consider this as the first equation. The feedback factor beta decides the input to be given to the amplifier. Okay. So here VF is equal to what? Minus beta into VO. As we know that beta, that is the gain of the feedback network, that is equal to output to that input. So here input is VO, output is VF. This minus sign indicates there is a 180 degree phase shift due to positive feedback. So from this we can get VF is equal to minus beta VO. Consider this as the second equation. So next we are going to substitute this first equation in the second equation. This VO can be replaced with the value A into VI. Then we can get VF is equal to minus beta into A into VI. We can write that equation as VF is equal to minus A beta into VI. Consider that as the third equation. For oscillator circuits, the feedback signal is given as input to the amplifier. Correct? Feedback is nothing but the input to the amplifier. So we can say Vf is equal to Vi for an oscillator circuit. Then the third equation can be written as Vi is equal to minus A beta into Vi. Then we can cancel these two values, right? We can get the answer as minus A beta is equal to 1. This is called as Berkashian criteria. So it is in rectangular form, that is A beta is equal to minus 1 plus J0. The imaginary part is 0 here. If you are going to take the magnitude for this loop gain, we can get modulus of A beta is equal to 1. Okay. Thus the magnitude of loop gain is unity. The first condition is obtained. Okay. Next, we have to prove the total phase shift required for this oscillation. So here the total phase shift around the closed loop is equal to the sum of phase shift introduced by inverting amplifier and the phase shift produced by the positive feedback. Correct? That is given as total phase shift around the closed loop is equal to 180 degree phase shift by inverting amplifier plus 180 degree phase shift by positive feedback. Here we can get total phase shift is equal to 360 degree. Thus the total phase shift around the loop is either 0 degree or 360 degree. It can also be mentioned like this, that is integral multiple of 2 pi radians. Okay. In these two conditions, the circuit works as an oscillator producing the sustained oscillation. Sustained oscillations means with constant frequency and constant amplitude. Okay. So next we are going to discuss the types of oscillations due to the A beta value. So we can say based on the magnitude of A beta, there are three types of oscillations. Okay. That is also known as the effect of A beta on the nature of oscillation. So first one is modulus of A beta is greater than 1. What will happen? So when the total phase shift around the closed loop is 360 degree or 0 degree, that first condition is okay. Here the next condition is greater than 1. In that case, the growing type of oscillations are produced. Do you understand? Growing means it is exponentially increasing its amplitude. So it can generate the signal, but its amplitude is exponentially increased. Second case, when the total phase shift is 360 degree or 0 degree, but the magnitude of A beta is less than 1, then it can produce the oscillations with decaying type. That means the amplitude of the signal is getting decreased exponentially. Okay, for A beta is less than 1, decaying type of oscillations are produced. Okay, then the last one, if A beta is equal to 1, that is the exact condition of Berkashian criterion. So when the total phase shift around the loop is 0 degree or 360 degree and A beta is equal to 1, then the sustained oscillations are produced with constant frequency and constant amplitude. So this is what we require for signal generation. Okay.